Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Well, I want you guys to relax. Elizabeth, this is probably the most memorable day you'll ever have besides having children. And it's a time that you've been waiting for 5 years on that mutual day, him trying to help you fix that car when actually he had other intentions. That date 5 years ago took you and takes you to an altar today. And we're so happy for you. And you look beautiful. I want you to just stop for a minute and turn around and let this crowd see you. Turn around. Doesn't she look beautiful? Give her a hand. I was getting started to change this last about 15 or 20 minutes and the dress is gone and it's over. It'll be put away, dry cleaned, and taken out on occasions. But we're glad for this moment. You're surrounded by people, family members, and friends that love you and will support you, not only on this day, but on the days to come. We love you and we're happy for you. And by the way, Jonathan, you clean up real well. Marriage, this first event took place in the Garden of Eden. It was in the time of man's innocence. Adam had just named all of creation, and as he did that, he realized something. He was alone. And God realized that man should not be alone. So, Jonathan, God was thinking about you. It's good that man's not alone. And he caused a great sleep to come upon Adam, and he took one of Adam's ribs, and he formed a woman. He brought that woman to Adam, and Adam looked at her and said, "That's bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she came from a man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and they too shall become one flesh." It's Jonathan and Elizabeth's desire today to become that one flesh. I had the privilege to counsel with them, chat with them, and feel like they're more than ready after 5 years of dating and engagement to make this commitment to one another. May God bless today this marriage covenant. So without delay, who gives this woman to marry this man?
My wife and I.
Unless you want to sit here and make those happen. And now Jonathan and Elizabeth, having freely, deliberately, and prayerfully chosen each other as life partners, I ask that you'll join hands. Well, Jonathan and Elizabeth, is there any reason why we shouldn't continue this wedding ceremony? No, okay. So let's have a wedding. Jonathan, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together after God's holy ordinance? In the estate of holy marriage, will you love her and comfort her and honor her and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, keep her only for yourself as long as you shall live. Elizabeth, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together after God's holy ordinance, in the estate of holy marriage? Will you love him and comfort him and honor him and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, keep him only for yourself as long as you shall live. Jonathan, will you repeat these holy vows after me? I, Jonathan, take you, Elizabeth, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I give you my pledge. Elizabeth, you repeat these words after me. I, Elizabeth, take you, Jonathan, to be my wedded husband, to have it a whole from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poor, in sickness and in health, To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I give you my pledge.
And thereto I give you my pledge.
Have you guys brought rings to this ceremony today? Well, both have brought rings today. These rings symbolize your constant faith and abiding love for one another. The Apostle Paul wrote a very great chapter that we're so familiar with. It's in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. It's called the Love Chapter. He says this, "Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. Love is not arrogant nor rude. Love does not rejoice in wrong, but rejoices in right. Love bears all things, believes all things, it hopes all things. Love never ends." Jonathan and Elizabeth, just as the circle and the rings that you brought today never end, so must your love for one another never end. Jonathan, take the ring that you brought today, place it on Elizabeth's finger, and repeat after me. As a pledge and token of the love between us shared, with this ring, I thee wed, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, amen. Elizabeth, take the ring that you brought today. Place it on Jonathan's finger and repeat after me. As a pledge and token of the love between us shared, with this ring, I thee wed, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, amen. Now we're going to turn this way to we're going to have a sand ceremony. I'm going to tell you a little bit about it. Jonathan and Elizabeth, today you're making a lifelong commitment to share the rest of your lives together. Your relationship today is symbolized through the pouring of these individual containers of sand. One represents you, Jonathan, all that you were, all that you are today, and all that you're going to be in the future. The other container represents you, Elizabeth, all that you were, all that you are today, and all that you will be. The sand on the bottom, it represents God. God should be the foundation of your marriage and of your lives. Other foundation can no man lay than that which was laid, which is Christ Jesus the Lord. Then your parents, they came and they poured sand into the container. And that represented, from this point, their individual families, but they are now joined together through your marriage. Each one of you will hold a container of sand. It will be unique at this moment and individual. But in a minute, it's going to be combined as two, becoming one. May the Lord bless the pouring of the sand. Fun. Well, we're almost done if you come back to the center here. This is, by the way, a fun couple. I've enjoyed speaking and knowing them, and they are fun. Well, Jonathan and Elizabeth were about finished. We said it takes longer to get ready than it does to actually have a ceremony, but you have the rest of your lives together. That's going to be neat. Marriage is a commitment for life to the best that two people can bring out of one another. It's going to offer you opportunities for sharing and growth that no other human relationship can offer. It's a joining of each other, a promise for a lifetime. While the circle of love, marriage encompasses all of the most important relationships, a wife and a husband are each other's best friend. You guys are best friends. You're each other's confidant. You can share with each other and tell each other secrets that no one in this room will know. They'll be yours for life. You're going to be lovers. Keep the romance in marriage, Jonathan. You'll be each other's teachers. This is a tough one, listeners. And worst of all, you're each other's critics. But I find that my wife is my best critic and my best friend. There comes a time when one partner's heart may be broken, and you'll have to come to the rescue. You'll be like that parent to a child. Your marriage deepens, it will be enriched. Your happiness will be fuller, your memories fresher, and your commitment stronger. Marriage understands and it forgives all the mistakes. Remember that, all the mistakes that life is unable to avoid. It encourages and nurtures new life, new experiences, and new ways of expressing love for one another through the seasons of life. Right now, it's the young newlywed. Some 50 years later, you'll be in the newspaper looking at, you know, celebrating 50 years. When two people pledge love and care for one another in marriage, it creates a spirit unique to themselves, which binds them closer than spoken words. Marriage is a promise of potential made in the hearts of two people who love, and it takes a lifetime. May God bless the union of these two hearts becoming one. Let us pray. Father, our hearts are filled with great joy and happiness, Lord, for Jonathan and Elizabeth. Lord, bless them as they pledge their hearts to one another. Lord, may they grow in love and kindness and understanding. Father, we ask that you'd help them to remember to be each other's best friend. Lord, to be each other's sweethearts. Lord, may their love for one another grow through this life. Guide them through the journeys, Lord, that they'll take. Lord, care for them. Lord, may their home be a place of love and harmony. Lord, may your spirit always be present. Lord, may their life prosper, and may they enjoy very good health. Father, we pray your blessing on them. Thank you for all those that are here today. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And now, by the powers invested in me as a gospel minister, and by the common laws of Virginia, I now pronounce you both husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Jonathan, what you've been waiting for? You may kiss your bride.
All right.
He'll turn to everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan Stevens.
stop taking now.
God damn it.
Pray. I have a few instructions for you today.
You have a crown. You will live a life of leisure.
either that you will struggle, you probably never have to work. Your Prince Charming is in middle school right now getting an education just for you. That's right. All right? You will live a life of luxury. I promise you, don't forget me, okay, when you come out with the building. All right? Very nice. You have the ring. You know what the ring means? I don't know when it is, but you're next to get married.
Your team is going to win the Super Bowl.